Welcome everyone again to another CS Music Masterclass. We're here with Meghan Picerno, who you might know as Christine from Phantom of the Opera. We're so happy to have you here, Meghan. And I am just going to turn the time right over to you and we can get started.
Awesome. And for everyone here, Mary's going to give me the heads up when we have a couple minutes so that, because I'm a talker, so well, she'll keep me reined in on track. Also, when I work with you, if you could also let me know your pronouns so I know how to address you properly, that would be wonderful for me and for everyone. So everyone, I hope that you come here with an open mind, open heart. Thank you for those who are singing. It's very brave of you to do so. And for all of you who are watching, thanks for coming to watch. I learned so much from observing. So I'm very happy to be here. So let's get this party started. So who's up again? See?
Yes. Hello, Meghan. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Fine. So I was going to do meine Lippen sie küssen so heiß by Franz Lehár.
Oh, yes. Great. Can you tell everyone what it's from?
It's from Giuditta, which is an operetta.
Great.
Okay. Just dive right in.
Let's dive right in.
Ich weiß es selber nicht, warum man gleich von Liebe spricht, wenn man in meiner Nähe ist, in meine Augen schaut und meine Hände küsst. Ich weiß es selber nicht, warum man von dem Sommer spricht, wenn keiner widersteht, wenn er mich sieht, wenn er an mir vorübergeht. Doch wenn das rote Licht erglüht zur mitternächtigen Stund und alle lauschen meinem Lied, dann wird mir klar der Grund. Meine Lippen, sie küssen so heiß, meine Glieder sind schmiegsam und focused on the technicalities and I'm not thinking about the passion.
Yes,
of the
song. That's what I want to get into, girl. Let's do it. So tell me who are you singing this? Why are you singing this?
So Giuditta is lamenting that the soldiers in the army the soldiers in the army camp don't want to get it on with me.
So can you tell, for those who perhaps don't speak German, I'm lucky, I actually do, but can you tell them, especially the part, meine Lippen, what are you saying there?
Meine Lippen means my lips, and it means meine Lippen sie küssen so heiß means my lips kiss so hot.
Ah.
Yes.
So, here's the thing, there's a few things. I definitely want to get into some playing with the diction. I mean, mm-hmm. right off the bat, before we also talk about being on camera, right?
Mm-hmm.
Lippen. How can you say, this is such a sexy song? So, could you play with the consonants or what do you have? So let's just say, let's just look right at that. Meine Lippen, what is it?
Sie küssen.
So you have Lippen, right? Mm-hmm. Like you're licking those lips. Right? Now here's something, and I hope this doesn't make anyone uncomfortable, but as a female identifying human, our femininity is so powerful, and we are goddesses, and it's so sexy. She knows exactly what she's doing. So, mm-hmm. You really play with my lip, and it's lip thin, right?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
What kind of consonants do you have there? You have my lip thin, you have...
Kussin.
Kuss.
Kiss, which means kiss.
Right? So, like that. Right? You can play with the S. And then hot is what?
Heiß.
Heiß. Like your...
Yes.
Yeah? Right there. And here's the thing that's, you know, it's so interesting when it comes to these kinds of songs that deal with a lot of sexuality. We have to, as the performer, really get in touch with our own sexuality, which can be sometimes uncomfortable or a little like, I don't know how to be sexy. It's okay. Everyone has their own flavor of sexiness, right? What I can recommend in general is when you're speaking about a very sexy song, for me personally, the center of gravity feels very low, which makes sense. So that's one thing. I would feel very like grounded to that floor. And you barely have to move because everything you do, yeah, you're saying that no one wants to get with you, but you know other people. Right? So it's that. That's one thing, which is a huge thing. And I'm going to have you do that right now. One more thing, though, when we do this next. When you are on Zoom, basically like you're kind of on TV. So mm-hmm. Watch this. Who am I singing to? However, if I'm looking right here, and for me, I know exactly who I'd be singing to. He is right there. And baby, he doesn't stand a chance.
Okay.
So can you do that for me?
Sure. Do you want me to start from the beginning?
No, again? No. Actually, can we start into it where it's like, meine Lippen sind Magie. There.
Okay, so that's, do you mean at the last part at the very end? That happens at the very end.
Yeah.
Okay, I'll skip the middle section then.
And I want you to play with those toys, with those consonants. Like you're taking a string and you're just winding it around your little finger, pulling him or her in. They're yours, baby.
Let's see. That's in the middles. Okay, we're close to it. Just a second. Sorry.
Okay,
here we go. My nose. Okay.
I know this is classical singer convention, but here's the crazy thing, the not so crazy thing. Sometimes when you're thinking more about being in the moment and what those delicious lyrics are, the voice just lines up and it plays exactly what it's supposed to do. So this time I want you to really, really feel those lyrics.
Okay.
Don't worry about did I breathe right, did I do this right, doesn't matter. The person that you think is the hottest thing on this universe is right in front of you, and you are seducing them, and you are winning at it, okay? So, words.
There we go.
You're doing great, Dorothy. You're doing great.
Here earlier.
tell you, that to me was so engaging. And also, I have another recommendation for you. When you do things on Zoom in this crazy virtual world that we're living in, I would say if you are comfortable to stand a little bit farther back, particularly in this kind of song, because, yeah, we'd like to see more of you, not just, like, up close, but just, like, yeah, you know what I mean? So that we can also see that, you know, what is your body doing? And, again, you don't have to do much, particularly in this song, and particularly when you are on screen. You're basically on TV, but truly, I would say for you, really, really play with the diction. Play with those double consonants. There's a reason they're stopping. Also, very quickly, listen to the accompaniment without singing. Notice how she uses many different manipulation tactics, right? And then all of a sudden it's slow. Just when a guy thinks, like, I've got her figured out, she's like, and now I'm going to do this. Didn't think you would. You know what I mean? So really have fun, play. Within even, like, 8 minutes, I already saw a different side of you. And that's the side I want to see through this role. Like, that's it. And do you see how, like, you're smiling? And it's just, it's exciting. It's wonderful. So really, lyrics. Be in the moment. And don't think about, like, finally. Nah, it's not what I want to see. I want to see, great job, Dorothy. I wish we had more time. That was wonderful. Thank you for making the changes.
Thank you.
Okay, awesome. Thank you, Dorothy. I think, Carly, you are next. So, Carly, if you will unmute yourself and introduce yourself.
Hello, my name is Carly.
Hey, Carly, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, thanks. Where are you calling from? Oh, I forgot to ask Dorothy where she's calling from.
I'm calling from LA.
Oh, LA. Oh, wonderful. Hello, LA. And Carly, where are you from?
I'm from Baltimore, Maryland.
Oh, Baltimore. Yes. Of course. And what are you going to sing today?
So I'm from the musical theater world. I cannot sing as wonderfully as you guys can. So.
Whoa, wait. Hang on. I'm going to stop you right there. Everyone brings their own amazing things to the table. So what are you going to sing for us today, Carly?
I'm going to sing No One Else from The Great Comet.
Beautiful. Love is in the air.
Yeah, I think so.
That full moon. Oh, well, how? Yeah, that full moon.
I know the most I know is that I'm a Pisces. I'm very Pisces. So that's all I can say about the moon.
Scorpio, fellow water sign. We're very passionate people. Yes.
The
voice, Carly, and it is so perfect for this song. So can you tell me, what would you like to get out of this short session?
Acting through the song.
Okay, another love song, but a very different kind of love song. Let me just say, a side note, plant yourself, ground yourself. Now, she's feeling all up here, but you, as Carly, have to make sure that you are nice and grounded and you don't go with her, okay? So that's one thing you're going to work on, and watching yourself. I have a feeling you know the words. I don't think you have to look at the words, right?
Yeah.
You know what? If you don't know the word, you blah, 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 and then keep going. That's okay. It's happened to me on stage before in front of thousands. It happens. It's okay. So, tell me, who are you?
I'm Natasha, and it's 1812 in Russia, and I'm missing my fiance.
Okay. Yes. Okay. Now, do you, Carly, if you are comfortable sharing, do you have a person that's, it may not be your fiance, I'm assuming, but you never know. But if it's not a fiance, a boyfriend, a girlfriend, someone, a crush, someone that you're just like, you do.
Yeah, I have two.
Oh, you have two. Okay, pick one. Lucky you. Pick one, the one that you're yearning for even more. And mm-hmm. You don't have to tell us who that is. Whoever that person is, they're going to be right in front of you, right? Mm-hmm. And I want you to talk to this person.
Mm-hmm.
I have more thoughts. Let's just try that again. Just standing still, and you're just having a conversation with your person.
Should I look at the mirror that's in front of me?
Oh, yes. I sing to myself all the time.
Yeah.
It's great, actually, because you can really see what you're doing, but also it's like my face transforms into the person that I'm singing to. I do this all the time. So, yes. So let's try that for now.
From the very beginning.
Yeah. And I'm definitely going to stop you probably like momentarily, but let's just try this. He's right there. He just kissed you. Or she. Carly.
Like me, myself, or the character I'm portraying?
No, you. What does your person's voice sound like?
Very light, but can be strong when I'm very motivated.
Okay. And what color are your person's eyes?
Brown.
Brown. Okay. This you don't have to answer, but you can think it. The moon. Seriously, how wonderful that we are in literally the biggest moon of the year tonight. You know, I don't know if you've ever been in a long-distance relationship, but I have, and I can tell you this. Sometimes when you're far away, you really will look up into the sky and think, well, I can't be with them, but maybe they're looking up at that same moon. So the moon is your connection to this person. So mm-hmm. I want you to hear their voice. I want you to see their eyes. I want you to also see what's the thing that really makes you smile. Do they bite their lip? Do they laugh? Like, what is it about them? Like, the way they smell? Like, really get in there. Like, whatever it is for you, I want you to have all of these feelings. And if, again, you don't have to tell us, if you guys have, let's say, had a first kiss, I want you to go back to what did you feel after that person held your hand or gave you a hug or kissed you. That's this feeling when she's starting. And it starts before she sings, right? Mm-hmm. Da, 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 da. Like, like, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Let's try it again. Brown eyes. Nice voice.
First time I heard your voice, moonlight.
fantastic. It's all in the subtleties. I can see it in your face now, right? This person is with you now, whoever that is. One more thing. So, and I catch my breath. We all know what that's like when you're like, oh, there the person is. That thing. I want to fast forward a little bit to the part where she's like, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. Now, whenever you have a lyric that is repeated over and over and over again, it's not, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. Can you try something without me giving you a direction? Can you make those I love yous different? And then we're going to try something. I'm going to ask you something after you do that. So can you fast forward a little bit to right before you can't help but say how much you love this person. Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't see.
It can be bombastic, like how I just did. Like, it can be very like, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. You know what I mean? It can be very like, but it is fire. Whether it's inside fire or outside fire, it's up to you. Literally perfect for this. So just have confidence that you have chosen a right song for you. Now, I'd like you to think about this. There's a couple ways that you could play with I love you, 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 right? Now, it could be one thought could be I just, like, you're almost like, I love you, I do love you, I love you, oh my gosh, I love you so much, I love you. What if he doesn't love you back? That's an interesting way to play it, yeah?
Mm-hmm.
It may not be the right way, but this is how, like, when you're discovering, see what happens if there's a little, like, oh my gosh, what if he doesn't love me? Mm-hmm. What if there's that robbed from you? Let's just play. Let's play. Try that. Oh, no. 2 minutes. Just left me in time. Now, how about this? He's in front of you and he walks away while you're saying I love you. How are you going? And you don't have to look at the words. You know the words. It's I love you, I love you, I love you. You got this, girl. You got this. You got this. All right? What if you're looking at him and you're like, I love you, and he just turns around? What are you going to do? Let's see it. Show me that. Start saying I love you and he kisses you in the middle of it. What is that going to do the I love yous? Let's try that. I don't know. We're going to find out. It was unexpected and you're like, you know what I mean? I mean, I know what I mean.
I know.
A very interesting palette to play with on these I love yous. Great. We have like a I want to talk about the ooh. Ooh, the ooh, ooh. You have to, just like in the opera world with coloratura, it's not just a vocal exercise. It's not you just having a very pretty like ooh, it's pretty. But what makes it thrilling is when there is a meaning behind the ooh. And you need to figure out, what is that for you? What is Carly Natasha? So whenever I wear a skin of a character, it's Meghan avataring with Christine, or Meghan avataring with Cunegonda, or whatever. You know what I mean? So Carly and Natasha need to come together, and you need to feel, what is the ooh for you? You know, mm-hmm. And what is the moon for you? And also really think about everything. This has so much beautiful text painting. The moonlight. There's something so magical and mysterious, and it's also at night. you know. So, you know what I mean? And also, marvelous. There's something mystical about it. So, oh, she's okay. We have time. Carly, you have a beautiful, beautiful voice. Keep working. And really, you know, another thing too, I have some advice for you is, if I may, own who you are. Own it. You, everyone here should own who they are. There's only one of us here in this lifetime. So that's your superpower. Huh? So Carly, own it, because you have such a gorgeous voice. So thank you. Thank you.
Thank you so much. Mm-hmm.
Awesome. Thank you, Carly. Okay, Casey, I believe you're next. Will you introduce yourself?
Hi there. I'm Casey. and I am calling in from Ludlow, Massachusetts.
Okay, Massachusetts. What would you like to sing today?
I will be singing If I Loved You from Carousel.
Ah, very nice. And what would you like to work on in this?
Oh man, this is a song that kind of came out of the vaults.
Okay.
So I haven't worked on it in a while, but I'd love to just add it to my rep because I love being a soprano and I've kind of been working on my mixed range and all that. So it's just nice to be back in this world.
Okay, bam.
Try to say, all I want you to know. If I loved you, words wouldn't come in an easy way. Round in circles, I'd go. To tell you, but afraid I'd try, I'd met my golden chances.
For me, can you do this again? And I would like you to move around this time.
Got it.
I want you to like interpretive dance.
Cool.
Like, swirls, feels. That's what you're gonna feel inside, because obviously you can't be like, if I love you. No. But I would like you to interpretive dance this time while singing. And yeah, you don't have to worry about your voice. The voice is gorge. So let's play. Yeah.
All right.
Let's play. Mm-hmm.
All right.
And I want you to like walk around in circles. If you're like, oh, we're gonna go here, and like, da, 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 and I'll stop you.
Yeah. Cool.
I love you. Time and again.
Shoot, I lost it. Okay, hold on.
Okay. Oh, please. You got this. And thank you for being game for my cray. Because this, let's do it again. We're going to do it again.
Cool.
And I think also, if I may request a movement, I want you to like, let's get these shoulders down. Like, can we just shrug them up and shrug them down? Yeah, and down. Up and down. And can you, as long as there's nothing in front of you, can you take your hand and go like this and then like whip it down without hurting yourself? You're going to take your arm.
I'm sorry. I am blind. Hold on a second.
Oh my gosh.
Okay.
Me too, girl. Yeah, we're on our classes together. Okay. So listen, like this, and you're going to go like this. Boom. without hurting yourself. Yeah, I want you to shake out your shoulders a little bit, because I see a little bit of this. Yeah, get those, get the ladies loose. Get them loose. Yeah, yeah, exactly. Yeah, blah, blah, blah. And you know, so some interpretive dance, what would I want to see? I want to see like a little sea creature. Whether or not it has to go, I don't care. Let's see the sea creature while you sing, okay? Start it again.
Stop it. There we go.
Yeah, 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 mm-hmm. Yes, yes. Your ballet doesn't have to be perfect. It's better than mine.
I'm so sorry. I can barely hear right recording. There it is.
I would try to say all.
Of course it. I am so sorry. App Pompous is being very temperamental.
It's okay.
There we go.
It's okay.
Hey, we're good. I promise.
If I want you, words would it come in easy way? Round in circles, I go. Longing to tell you, but afraid and shy.
Okay, listen. So here's the deal. I saw something really fascinating here this time around. And I would love for you to keep doing it when you're not moving so much. It's the release of emotion in your face. So a lot of us, when we're singing, have singer face. We know singer face, right? Where it's like, or, you know, this. Or, and it's so much easier when you're doing it with someone in the scene, right? Because if you've got the guy there, you're singing to him as opposed to like, we are now doing this right now.
If I loved you, time and again.
So that joy that was coming out, because like that's, she's saying, if I love you, she does love him. So like that joy of you dancing, that needs to stay like in here while you're, oh, ladies coming out. while you're singing this, okay? So let's try, now, I like your groundedness. This song needs that, but let's have the play inside, okay? I need to see that, and it doesn't have to be like, no. But what you just did when you were dancing, that's what I need to see in this song, yeah? So still think that you're dancing.
Cool.
Okay, let's do it again. And remember, if I were you with this song, she actually says right before, but somehow I can see just exactly how it'd be, right? That's what she says right before she sings this, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
If I loved you, time and again I would try to say, all I want you to know. If I loved you, words wouldn't come in an easy way. Round in circles, I'd go.
Good. I'm going to stop you there too. Now, know this too. It is very strong to stay still, but if you want and have the impulse to make a gesture, do it. Because I saw like once you're like, the hand was like, we want to do, no, we're gonna go back down here. We're gonna stay down. If you want to, now, however, make sure the gesture has purpose. No singer baritone claw. I don't know what that is. Like, wah, 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 wah. No, like this, no, that, you know, unless it's purposely done. But if Julie Jordan isn't doing it, you can't either. But if you want to do something, do it. Do it again. Good. Also, I really need to see your person. For you too. Whoever that person may be, that lucky person may be. 2 minutes. Okay. Whoever that lucky person is for you, you're singing to them and you're flirting. You're like kind of like, eh. You know what I mean? Like, You guys are totally flirting because you both love each other. Okay, so that person, you're singing to that person. And the person said the same thing to you. You both know you love each other, but you're like, well, if I did, you know, this is what it would be. But, you know, I don't, so it's fine. But, you know, I do, but I don't, you know. Yeah? Okay, here we go. Oh, yeah, there's your person. Hello.
I would try to say all I'd want you to know. If I loved you, words wouldn't come in an easy way, rounding circles I'd go.
Okay, good. Great. I'm going to stop you one more time because you did something that I was so happy you did. So, Julie has never said these words before, right? Casey has said these words before, but Julie has not. So, you're right. She doesn't know what she's going to say next. So, you're right. Like, round in circles I'd go. I would do, what else? So, something that you can do as an exercise is, what else? You can think that between each thing. I would do this, and what else would I do? I would do that too. And because she's going with it, right? So that is exactly, it's organic. It's almost a list, actually, quite frankly. If I loved you, I'd do this, I'd do this, I'd do this. But like with any list, whether it's in Mozart or it's here, you don't know what the list is yet. You have to discover it each time. And play also, I love that your take on this is like, well, if I loved you. So try that. Try something also that is so opposite of Casey too. So like, it's really great, and I've done this now with all three of you, is to find things like, what if you did the exact opposite of what would make sense? You know what I mean? Like, and then you suddenly have an array of interesting choices that you're like, wow, I never thought I would do it that way, or do the less obvious choice sometimes. That's another thing. And in general, for everyone that is watching today, particularly in this very Zoom-heavy and self-tape world, no matter if you're in opera or Broadway or TV, tape yourself and watch yourself. I mean, it might be a little awkward and strange and painful for the first few times, at least it was for me. And then you're like, okay. And like really see like, oh, that's what I like that. Oh, I want to change that. So tape yourself because it's fascinating how already it's changed so much. Yeah. Oh, that's it. I'm getting the, we got to go. Thank you so much. Beautiful voice, though. Beautiful, beautiful.
I'm so sorry. I have to be the bad guy. Casey, that was so much fun. That was great. You were so brave. I thought that was awesome. So, okay, Abby, would you introduce yourself, please?
Hi, Meghan.
Hey, Abby. How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. Where are you calling from?
I'm calling from Naperville, Illinois, Chicago suburbs.
Naperville?
Yeah.
I'm from LaGrange.
No way. That's so close by.
I know. My ex-boyfriend from senior year is from Naperville.
That's so funny.
Very long time. Anyway, okay. So what would you like to sing today?
I'm going to be singing a short song. I'll be singing Once You See from Carrie the Musical.
Oh, okay. We're going to dive in. Let's do it.
Song sung by Sue and not Carrie.
Oh, yes. Yes.
Won't go too heavy today. All right.
The blood moon, not too much today. Okay.
All right.
So, what would you like to work on?
I think for me, sometimes something that I tend to do is overact or kind of like be presentational when I perform. And so that's something I'm trying to work on when it comes to musical theater. And so just kind of being in the moment and staying authentic. That's kind of what I want to work on today. So
I got you. Okay.
All right.
For years you look at someone passing by, and then one day you see her, one day you finally see her. My God, she shook. And then she looked me in the eye,
I'd never seen her angry. I hate I made her angry. She's always been there. I never knew. I felt as though this girl revealed herself to me. And now I know that once you see, you can't unsee.
Oh, beautiful. Oh my gosh, everyone is such a great voice. This is lovely. Okay, so here's something interesting. Actually, I have to tell you, I loved the stillness that you held on to during particularly this song. Now, I'm wondering, do you have anything else? Maybe?
Sure. Let me think what I have. I have a couple songs, they're kind of long, and so that's why I'm trying to think. I have The Girl in 14G, that's a little bit more comedic.
Let's do this.
A little bit of that? Okay, it's pretty long, so do you want me to just do a cut?
Let's see. Well, yeah, this is, Girl in 14G is an interesting one, because
it is.
This is where I'm curious, because I have to tell you, like, I loved how subtle your facial expressions were, and grounded you were in that song, we could really get into the nitty gritty of the acting of it.
Sure.
We need way more than 8 minutes for that. And I really did it fully. So,
okay, thanks.
14G is fascinating because there is a little melodrama.
Sure.
But it has to be true.
So, yeah.
Yeah, let's do that.
Better sure. All right. Just stop me whenever.
You know, so Hal Prince was one of my mentors, and something he always said to me, I mean, look, Phantom, Cunegonda, a lot of these roles, they are melodramatic, but the seed of truth always has to be there. So as long as that seed is genuine, it can be massive, but it's genuine. It's not,
okay.
You know what I mean?
It's
genuine. So, and 14G, the cool thing about this, if someone pulls it off, is it's three distinct characters, right?
Yes.
So, let's see what you got.
Alrighty.
I know, I put you on the spot.
Oh no, it's okay, this is fun. All right.
I just moved into 14G, so cozy, calm, and peaceful. Heaven for a mouse like me. With quiet vibe.
Question for you. Are you really the mouse like you? Because you seem to me that you would be like, oh my gosh, I'm going to meet everyone in this building right now.
Oh yeah.
Come on. So can we see the mouse like you who likes to read a little book in the nook and have a little cup of tea and have like those really quiet little nights?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Okay. Let me try one again.
An introvert's dream.
Absolutely. Alrighty.
I just moved in.
Oh. Sorry. That's a mind of its own. All right.
I just moved in to 14G. So cozy, calm, and peaceful. Heaven for a mouse like me. With quiet by the leaseful. Pets are banned. Parties too. And no solicitation.
Okay, another question for you here. So this is where, like, subtle is very funny. She's thrilled that there cannot be parties here, right? Pets are banned, which means no dog noises. Uh-oh, is it me? Is it you? Oh, here we are. Pets are banned. This is great. Parties too. Huzzah. I'm so excited I'm here, but it's going to be just as I dreamed. Peaceful, quiet. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's more subtle.
Okay. A little more subtle. But she's also, the thing about this too, she's a subtle person until she finds her voice at the end, right? But she's like, I can't believe I just said stop. And she's like, oh my God, it feels so good. You know?
Yes, that's true.
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. I'll go back just a tad.
She's feisty, but it's all inside.
Yes. Okay. Sorry, I'm not familiar with this track. It's taking a sec. Oh my, this is not the time to load. There we go.
Parties too, and no solicitations. Window seat with garden view. Read a book. I'm lost in my Jane Austen when I hear. Ah!
Okay, great. This is why I love this. Fabulous. And I love that. Now, you're just as like confident. She's like, oh, I love it. I love the switch. But I want to see the same confidence that you were when you were Mouse Girl in 14G, when you're like, ah! You're a full-on opera diva. So let me tell you some cues here. An opera diva, she won't be like, if someone blinks a lot, it usually means that they're uncomfortable or they're nervous or worried, like, oh my gosh, I don't know if I'm gonna get it or not. This is the challenge of the song, right? Because you're singing jazz, you're singing contemporary, and you're singing opera. But Kristen Chenoweth can, so, and you can too. So when you do the switch to opera diva, this is a different energy, right? So you have like 14G, which is kind of like here. Opera diva is whoop-hum. Like, you will throw roses at me and everything. Oh, that wasn't a wrong note. I chose to do the wrong note. You know what I mean? Like, as over the top, but true and confident. Oh, whatever it is. You know what I mean? No, don't tell me to. All right, I want to see that switch again, if you can fast forward it, because that was great. And I loved when you came back deadpan, like, are you kidding me? She's really doing this? Like, fab. Great. Those switches need to be just like that and so confident. Like, boom, boom, boom.
Perfect. Okay.
When I hear, say it isn't so, not the flat below, from an opera wannabe in 13G, a matinee of some cantata, Wagner's Ring and Traviata.
Okay, great. Oh, this is such a great song. You have the voice for it. Stand still for the opera. Stand still. Park and bark for that, baby. Less is more in the opera. Okay, try that. Try it. It might feel a little contained, but I guarantee you it'll be, yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
A matinee of some cantata, Wagner's Ring and Traviata.
Word of advice for this song, pick three different distinct kinds of centers of gravity, even though, yes, you have one that's always grounded. My opinion, take or leave, if it helps you, 14G is kind of like, it's here, and like opera is like, boom, here, and a do-tweet is like really low, right? So you got all of them happening. So at the end, when you're doing all the three voices, you're literally doing three complete humans then at the same time. But that was great. As soon as you switch into the opera, it is boom, park and bark. Ha, bah, that you do baritone claw. Things are slow and moving and huh, yeah? This is a great song for you. Oh my
gosh.
Thank
you so much.
Lovely, lovely. Yes.
It helps so much. Thank you.
Great job.
Awesome, Abby. Thank you. Okay, Catherine, I believe you are our last singer. Will you introduce yourself?
Hi.
Hey, Catherine. How are you? are you?
Good.
Long time to see.
I know. Yeah.
So what are you going to sing for us today?
Warm All Over.
Oh, perfect.
Cool. All right.
Oh, and what would you like to work on today?
This is new. So just like anything.
Oh, love it. Okay, let's go. Okay, love great. It. Love it. Let's
we're
go.
We're being brave. We're doing a new song.
Ta-da!
Where's that smile? Where's that glow? Where's that happy face that I depend on so? Why didn't you know? It makes me feel
when you're talking about this kind of a song, you really want to get into how do you make a song like this have different stakes, right? Different levels.
Right.
However, I want to talk about a couple other things first. The style of a song, yes, indeed, you are going to portamento, you will scoop some. However, also if I had a dime for every time someone told me this in Phantom, you got to pick.
Yeah.
We'll pick. Which warms all overs? You will pick which ones as opposed to all of them. Because if all of them are done that way, it loses the magic. It loses the different spices that are being used. Do you know what I mean? If it's,
yeah.
Okay, it's always happening. All of them. Yes. We're all going all over. So let's try it again. And I want you to actually choose when you will purposely slide in or out or portamento or not.
Okay, cool.
And I'll stop you because I have some other things too. Okay.
Great.
Where's that smile? Where's that glow?
Even that. So we have the word where, right? Where. So yes, mm-hmm. You can do HW, if you're talking IPA, where, nah. For this, I personally would not. But where, be careful. The is a great tool, but also she can be tricky because she can make you slide because she's a blind. So, where's that smile? Where's that glow? Whatever it is.
Okay.
Can you make them, even if it feels constrictive at the moment, crystal clear right in the middle? You're singing it better than I am. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
In fact, let's take the words out. Let's say ba 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 Do that again.
Beep, beep, beep. Beep, beep, beep. Beep, 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 beep. Beep, 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 beep.
Oh, fascinating. You're still scooping. Okay, hang on, hang on. Wait, how about K? Okay.
Ki, ki, ki. Ki, ki, ki. Ki, 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 ki. Ki, 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 ki. We can go for that.
Now, say the words for me there. What's the words? Just say them.
Where's that smile? Where's that glow? Where's that happy face that I depend on so?
Okay, can we ki-ki-ki in speaking it? Literally just have the conversation. Don't sing it, don't slide into it. Where's that smile? Where's that glow? Very simple, very plain, very, it's just happening. Can we do it with the track?
Yes.
Right there.
Wait, on key? On key or on the lyrics?
Singing.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. But clean. Clean, very conversational at the beginning.
Where's that smile? Where's that glow? Where's that happy face that I depend on so? Or didn't you know? It makes me feel
okay, I have another little thing for you. Because this is a very fascinating piece because it kind of goes up, right? It goes in your presaggio, it comes down in your presaggio, and you're like, ah! So, can you do this for me? Can you make a sound like you're a trombone or trumpet, like, right? Can you do the whole thing on... Oh, you know. With the track.
Oh, okay.
And really make sure you breathe. Okay. Do you feel the breath pressure and how consistent it is?
Yeah.
Can we try to sing it again?
Yeah.
Where's that smile?
How about this? Can you do this for me? You're in and out of tromboning.
Okay.
Maestro.
Alright, cool. My phone is glitching, so we don't have that option anymore.
Okay, fair. So a cappella, trombone into singing. Oh, and I Beautiful. Think we're almost done anyway, but give it a try real quick.
Okay. Where's that smile? Where's that glow? Where's that happy face that I depend on so?
you too. Warm. Is that an, what is that? An F, a D, an F sharp, an E. What is it?
I think it's E flat.
E flat. It's right in the passaggio. Something you could also try is breathing through your nose before you sing that note.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Because it helps lift the soft palate, which when you're in the passaggio, you want a little bit more extra space, right?
Yeah.
Even though can go flat. But I love what you're doing with the vowels. Or whatever. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But listen, the trombone thing really helped you. It keeps it nice and speaky, but connected to your chest, but not, where's that smile? Mm.
Yeah.
Where's that smile? Where's that glow? You know, yeah?
Yeah.
There you go. Thanks for being brave and just diving in with it. Great.
Yeah, of course. Thanks.
Yeah. Gorgeous voice. Oh my gosh. So gorgeous.
Thanks.
All right, everyone. I can't believe it's so fast.
It's great. No, this has been fantastic. And thank you, Catherine. So we have about, 9 minutes exactly. We have to cut off at a quarter to the hour. So we have 9 minutes for questions. So I know that everybody has a question. So if you have one, you can type it into the chat or raise your hand. And it looks like Kaylin's very first one. So go ahead, Kaylin, unmute yourself.
Hi, first of all, this has been so good. It's been really nice to hear from you. So thank you for that. Also, sorry, I sound a little sniffly. I have a cold. But also, as someone who is a vocal instructor and also I sing a lot of classical and opera songs, what are some other tips that you have for raising the soft palate? I feel like that's a really like big struggle that me and like some of my students have had, is getting that, like finding that space and finding that, like, you know, just lifting it in general has always been really hard for me.
Sure. Depending on how, what age group your student, what are they in general?
Young, like I think from like third grade to early middle school.
Okay, so kids basically, right?
Basically kids, yeah.
The first thing you could do is have them yawn, right? Is that, no matter what, it's gonna lift the soft palate, right?
Yeah.
All right, and as long as their hands are clean. Something I like to do too is have them either trace with the tip of their tongue, or honestly the finger is better, but like have them actually go so they can anatomically feel from behind their teeth, and then it's hard palate, hard, up, it's soft, like aptly named, right? So they can actually be like, oh, my soft palate. I mean, don't gag yourself, but like, oh, it's there, right? So have them yawn, have them actually feel where that is. Indeed, taking a nose breath, and you can have them do this too. You can ask them to take a breath through their mouth and tell, what does that feel like? And then you can have them only breathe through their nose. And then you can have them breathe through their nose and their mouth, which honestly will cause a little bit of confusion, but then they'll get it. It'll be like, and they'll be like, oh, you know what I mean? So that is one thing. Now, depending on where you are in your range, and this is mostly for female anatomy, okay? I'm speaking for myself here.
But, okay.
In the passaggio, taking a breath through the nose really does help. When I'm in my lower range, flaring my nostrils. Can everyone feel nostrils? Can you feel suddenly there's cold air happening?
Yeah.
So if I'm now in music theater, I don't use this very much, to be honest. But in opera, if I'm singing like kind of chesty, it's like la, it's like there kind of. Mm-hmm. I'll flare a little bit because the muscles that help flare your nose also bring up hair a smidge. Also, one more thing.
Okay.
You see opera singers, old opera singers kind of do this. You see what I'm doing with my cheeks here?
Yeah.
That brings up the soft palate too.
Oh, okay.
Also, one more thing. And this is only a tool if you're in trouble. If you ever see anyone singing out of the side of their mouth, this also raises your soft palate.
Oh, all right.
Felt better. But you look crazy, one. And two, with all the HD performances happening, it's not as great. But like, if I'm really tired, I sometimes will.
Okay, good to know.
Yeah.
Thank you so much. Thank you. It really means a lot to me.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, that was awesome. Okay, Alina, and I have to warn everybody, we probably will run out of time. So we probably will not get to everybody, but we're gonna do as best we can. Okay, so Alina.
Hi, okay, so in the musical theater world, you know, that big Broadway wide sounding belt, which tends to be kind of nasally, I notice it sometimes gives me intonation issues, and I don't know if it's just because I've placed it too far forward in my mask, but I've also gotten feedback from other CS music judges because they say I have a great mix, but they'd like to hear my bell and they also want to hear me from my soft palate, but I'm not sure what kind of changes I need to make in my placement and how I place things to be singing from my hard palate and give a good Broadway bell.
Uh-huh. Okay, so I'd have to actually hear you to really like give my thoughts and feedback, but I can tell you this. Of course there's Beltane, but I have a team of opera singers who teach me opera and a team of music theater, and so my teacher is Matt Farnsworth. He's amazing. And he teaches something that's not just belting, it's belxing, right? So for instance, if you've heard Elphaba on Wicked, she's probably his student. Dear Evan Hansen, his student. They can belt their faces off 8 shows a week and be healthy. Why? It's not just in the mask. It is very connected to chest. And it is far more mixy than belty, right? So you're gonna be dealing with a lot of what's your breath pressure? What kind of breath are you taking? What's your tongue doing? Indeed, it's not just about shoving it into the mask. You will actually have intonation problems, of course, because you're gonna be flattening out, speaking of the soft palate. Also, the propensity to go sharp is huge because you're pushing so much air into there. So it has to deal with really the mixing of your chest and bringing the chest up healthily into, you know, here's a very, so I'm not a belter, I'm a belter, mixer. Mix. I would do more mixing, but let's say for instance, let's just use these 3 different characters. Opera, this is how I very basically think about opera, as a column, all right? It's like this. I think about Legit and Christine music theater, sopranos, like this. It's more like this. Linda, I think like this.
Nyeh, nyeh, nyeh. Is that going to be kind of like your Little Shop of Horrors sound too? Kind of like that whole little nasally?
Yeah, and here's the thing about that. Depending on all of those different roles that you may be auditioning for or you're portraying, how you warm up will also help you or hinder you with what type of repertoire you're doing. I would never warm up for Glinda like I do Christine, or definitely not Queen of the Night. Like, I barely make a peep up above the staff when I'm going on for Christine. Otherwise, I won't get through the role. So this is another thing, but truly it's not, there is this misconception about belting that it's all like, good luck, you won't make it 8 shows a week. So it is very much supported in chest and head, but there's so much to say there, but I don't know if that steers you in a direction. Perhaps you can look into more.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay, that's fantastic. Okay, I apologize. This is probably going to be the very last question, but Amanda Garcia, do you want to go ahead and unmute yourself?
Yes. Hello. Thank you so much for this class. I just wanted to ask about singing opera and acting in opera. I know usually it's kind of more, from what I've seen and been told, like to be more calm or more just in place. And I wanted to know if you had any advice on or any ideas that can that be changed or in that kind of thing.
Okay, these are my very strong personal opinions. Yes. And like I tell you, some of my favorite opera singers, regardless what you may think of their voice, this and that, like, have you ever seen Natalie Dessay on stage or Deanna Damrau? Oh my gosh! Like, you know why? Because everything that they're doing vocally, they're also physically in it. And that's what makes it thrilling, because it's vocal acrobatics, and yet everything in their being is true to what they are doing. That is the most impressive and exciting kind of opera. And quite frankly, as generations literally die off and like new ones come, you can't just stand there anymore and be like, I love you so much and I'm going to stand over here and say how much I love you. Okay, right, I really believed you. So just like in music theater, I have to tell you one thing that's really amazing being a crossover artist is the tools I have learned in opera, I've brought over and changed and, you know, adapted to music theater. I mean, look, I won't do like Rock of Ages ever in my life. It's not in my, but at the same time too, all of the wonderful tools I've learned now in on Broadway, I will be bringing back to the opera world, which is being in the moment. What are the lyrics? But you know, here's the thing. That was always the case for me, even when I was singing opera. It wasn't just like, what is that? What are those? You need purpose for every trill, every melisma, every, otherwise it's just a vocal exercise. And like, that's great for like 5 minutes, but when the opera is like 4 hours long, I mean, so yes, it is my hope. And everything that I am seeing, by the way, is more and more, you must think about acting. And I know that we have to wrap up, but I really think that there's a disservice that's being done in general to opera singers. And this is my experience too. We need acting classes. We have this bad rap that we can't act, but it's because we're not taught. That's all. And gone are the days of Pavarotti with his handkerchief just singing his beautiful high C's. That doesn't mean that you can't be still. You have to know when to move and why you're doing it, right? There needs to be purpose to everything that you do. And yes, you can sing and move. Yes, and do it. And there are times that you do need stillness to make sure that you're hitting the high cue or sure. But the blend of that is possible. So for all of you that are opera singers, young opera singers, I suggest go do the uncomfortable thing. Go take an acting class. You might feel like, I don't know what to do because like there's no music under the words. But even if you feel like a complete fool and like, I'm never doing that ever again, I guarantee your opera is going to be way better. I guarantee you. So all of you, go take opera acting classes outside of your conservatories, because this is the thing too, not acting for opera singers. No, acting, take acting. I feel very passionate about this.
I think that's wonderful advice. And thank you so much for your question, Amanda. And thank you everyone for being here tonight. I wish we had unlimited time. We could just ask lots of questions, but Meghan, you've been wonderful. Thank you so much for sharing your time with us.
Thank you for having me. And thank you for sharing. Oh my gosh. Beautiful talent. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh my gosh. And Meghan, you look like Liv Tyler.
But thank you. I'll take it. She's a little taller than me, but that's fine.
Oh, this was so much fun and so informative. It was so wonderful. And everybody did such a beautiful job.
Yes. Thank you everyone so much for being here.
Bye, everyone.
Have a good night.